this great land we call home. Black and white, now we're living together. In this land we love.
Hello, my name is Ephraim Binary. I grew up in a little small community called Wangkatjungka, and yeah, we love playing music there. This health and healing program took us out to the bush and to learn about how music does affect you. It was something new and bigger to open our eyes and stuff, you know. It's about learning about music and getting connection together.
Well, my name is Jake and I play in the Rocky Ridge Band. The help and healing project, it was really good for me and the boys. He helped me and the other mob to realize too, you know, get up on our feet to for our music and help everybody else too when we get the chance. When I was smaller, I used to look at my big brothers, big sister playing. And one day I was thinking, one day I'll start a band and I'll be like them and help other mob.
As a musician, even though that's my first and foremost love, as it were, I mean, it's one of those things that I've discovered just recently, and it comes out of the depth of my heart. Now, for instance, if I write a blues lyrics, I pick up the guitar, which is my friend, and me and the guitar strike up a tune. When I'm lonely, when I'm heartbroken, when no one cares, or things around me aren't working, abandonment, I pick up a guitar and write a lyric on it. I write poetry, taking my blues away. So that's truth, because I feel it from the heart.
Music can help people from struggling. It'll keep them occupied, keep them, stop them from thinking about doing suicide and stuff. And it'll make everybody busy and happy. I want to see, yeah, see more happening in the communities. What like the desert feed mob doing to go out in the community, because we need more remote people like that now.
Of course, it's very common in our communities where young people resort to drugs because of a deep-rooted problem. The truth is that these people are struggling. There's depression, and there's a lot of other issues. There's compounded issues from the past that they need to get their story out. Now, who's listening to these people?
Years going back, talking about suicidal, Kimberley was the highest rate of suicidal, and yeah, I have friends and family who suicide and loved ones. It's really been hurting us and the families and the friends. That's why I want to keep this legacy, helping people got problems. You gotta always tell somebody if you're feeling no good inside. Try to tell them what you're feeling no good about. Especially men, yeah, they're the most kind of people that you can't get a word out of. And that's why these kind of programs, like taking men and stuff out and talking and finding out what's happening inside of them, it's good, like, to help them.
I wrote something that I felt that I needed to write about. And anyway, the leader of the group said, look, read it silently to yourself, and then read it quietly, read it again, and again, louder and louder. And eventually, the story became just another story. It wasn't no longer something that I felt, the hurt and the pain. It was another story I told. This is the beauty of it, see? Now, the younger kids will sing the story, and learn the story over and over again. And the person, the writer himself, who possibly have carried the pain, will hear it out there, sung by the siblings or whoever, you know, and they'll hear the story over and over and over again till it becomes another story.
Why carry your loads and still why carry your load? Why carry your load?
Pain does restrict, as you know. Pain is, frankly, leaves you crippled. So if you can find something outside of you, writing music or songs, and then you begin to heal with your own, what you put on paper and what you speak about and all that sort of thing.
They're often troubled by noises like that.
We got Walmadjarri, we got Wangkatjungka, we got mixed Gugaja, but we just like, you know, mixing the music up and singing different language songs for different people so they understand where we're coming from. So we're all dancing as one. Yeah.
It's something different to take young people out to the bush and get them out of the media world for change, come out to the bush and reconnect to the land. And this little thing, we can take it to any community and start doing what we've done back at Wangkatjungka. This healing program will grow fast.
Back in Wangkatjungka day, we can do music therapy, but you can find a new way to encourage other mob to play music instead of they can do that and not going drinking and smoking, you know? It's a good thing we can do that, and I think that's it for mob to take bringing me and or bringing news here. Yeah? And yeah, but that thing about music therapy, it can help us, you know? Like I'm up here, I'm helping Mala, and we're playing a different sound. Now we come back, we're playing Valga Way, then I think there before, you know? That, like, that's what I mean, you know? We're playing Valga Way, and today we can come back and make them sound better, see? That's what you can do from music therapy. Okay, thank you, Mop.
Make sure if you're feeling hurt inside, or women's, make sure check your local service provider or Aboriginal liaison provider or someone, so where we all can keep together as young generation. We want to carry this generation to be strong and to listen and to talk to one another. I'm